I'm DJ Schurz, CEO and founder of Easy Robot. Obviously, as a child, I was really interested in robotics, electronics, anything that moved, took batteries. I was actually in trouble a lot for taking apart every toy I was ever given. My mother used to come downstairs and see that the toy she got me for my birthday was taken apart and crazy glued to another toy that I got the previous birthday to try to make it into something totally different. And it was just my imagination running wild with me. As I got older, the computer revolution set into place, which allowed me to sit in front of a computer and start writing code and making programs to do unreal things. And part of that, my obsession as a child, was to have my computer talk to me through artificial intelligence. And eventually, when mechanics got involved, for example, what Easy Robot is doing, we were suddenly in a position as society, not just myself, to take that artificial intelligence and software and apply it to robotics and actually have your robot not just talk to you, but do things at the same time. When I'm asked what science fiction or what kind of books I was into when I was a child, my first answer, which is kind of funny, was Dr. Seuss. As a, you know, even at the age of 12, 13, I was still looking at Dr. Seuss books. I'd pull them out and look at them. And it wasn't the story so much as I got older that I was interested in. It was the little mechanical designs. Dr. Seuss, I don't know if you remember, but he would have these crazy little contraptions that would do things. Cars with all these wheels and gears and long extended pieces with cages and weights and distributions and stuff. It's really neat to see. So as a child, I would always try to figure out, you know, what these were. It was kind of like the Lego for my imagination. And as I got older, I started getting involved in different types of science fiction books. My biggest, which I'm actually listening to right now, is Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. You got Marvin, the paranoid android robot, and you have space travel and time travel, and you have all of these really funny quirks that kind of mock science, but they mock science in a way that scientists can't really defend themselves on. So it's pretty funny because there's a lot of interesting humor in science fiction as well. Education and robotics go hand in hand because there's so many disciplines to robotics. For example, there's math, there's programming, there's mechanical engineering, there's a creative aspect which also uses a lot of art. When you look at the history of art and how creative you can truly be with strange objects and put them together to come out with something. And what Easy Robot is doing is giving people the ability to create the robot without needing to understand all the different disciplines. Educational institutions are beginning to recognize that robotics is not just a whole chunk called robotics. There's many different pieces of it. And students can choose which path they want to take. Perhaps you want to go into electrical engineering. Perhaps you want to go into the mechanical design. But when you're done, you end up in a career of robotics. And that's something that's been unheard of until today. Imagination to a child is like gasoline to an engine. It truly is the fuel of being a child. And it's the one time in your life where society doesn't judge you for asking questions and pushing the limits. I'm somewhat guilty of reading more source code than I am of books. And when I do read source code, I can relate it to what it's like to read a novel or read a book, because you're living in your imagination and your fingers are outputting your creative design and whatever it is you're imagining. And your computer becomes that template, that empty canvas for you to be able to create on. And I feel that when you read a book, for example, this is an amazing book, and from James Patterson. And when you read a book like this, even though there are some diagrams and pictures inside of the book as well, you sometimes don't even end up looking at the photos other than to read the captions, because your imagination fills in the blank, fills in the rest. I'm truly jealous of the opportunity that children have in today's day of age. iPads, iPhones, Android devices, computers, programming languages, everywhere. PHP, Perl, all this may sound confusing to you now at a young age, but as you grow older, you're going to be able to choose. You have the option to choose programming languages, the option to choose robot platforms, the option to choose career paths that were never offered to your parents or myself. And it's amazing to imagine what the world's going to be like in the future. And I'm really excited to be here and see what's going to happen at this day of an age. I couldn't expect to be at any point in the history. I would like to be here in another 100 years, but I don't think that's going to happen, unless it's up to you as children to come up with a time machine or at least some sort of robot android shell that you can put me into. So maybe that's a job for you.